One of the things which was really surprising was one of the patients using the prosthesis, shaking the hand of Francesco, the main author of the study, and saying like, it feels human.
This hand is the first wearable bionic hand which allows amputees to feel temperature in their phantom hand.
Yes, my name is Soleiman Shokur. I am a senior scientist and lecturer at the Polytechnic of Lausanne. As a laboratory, we work on techniques for amputees to recover hand function. So we work with upper limb amputees. There's one thing that is always missing for amputees, it is sensory feedback. And sensory feedback is essential for them to recover also some level of motor functions, because if I'm trying to grasp something and I have to rely only on vision, that is going to give me a very limited functionality. I need to feel when I'm touching it. That is the one we started working on about 4 years ago. A very good point. We did check it on 27 amputees, all of them with traumatic amputation, traumatic lesions, and all of them upper limb. And over 27, 17 of them had phantom thermal sensations. Now, it is possible that among the 10 that did not have it, by playing a little bit, by calibrating a bit better our system, some of them might have also phantom thermal sensation. I would say probably a few of them will never have thermal sensation, because maybe if it's an amputation due to electrocution or anything that burns the skin, then really the thermal sensation is gone. Nice. As a first test, we managed to have 17 out of, so about 60-something percent, so a bit more than the half of them. So it's not in all of them, but at the same time, it is in the majority of the patients that we have checked. So how we do that is we have the mini-touch has three elements. This little sensor that we integrate here in the fingertip of the prosthesis. And this sensor not only measures the temperature of the objects that this hand will be in contact with, but also maintains baseline skin temperature. This sensor will maintain 32 degrees when you're in contact with nothing. And when you touch something, the temperature might decrease. If I touch a piece of metal, for example, it will decrease the same way that the temperature of my fingertip decreases when I touch an object that is metallic one. Then this sensor, which now is disconnected, goes to this controller. And this control will simply measure the temperature in real time, like 20 times per second. It will measure that. And it will convey that temperature to this element. And this is what we call a Peltier element here. So this is the little element that will be in contact with the skin on the residual arm. So this will be somewhere in contact with the amputated hand. We, as a laboratory, we concentrate on upper limbs. Yes, it could also be used for other body parts. We have one part of our laboratory that works on prosthetics for lower limb. We have never yet tried thermal feedback there, but it's a good idea, and it's something that it is in the pipeline for us, let's say. It's something that we are interested in. Yes. It increased, let's say, their palette of sensations. But beyond that, what we found is that in some cases, phantom thermal sensation reduces phantom limb pain. Really painful sensation that the vast majority of amputees have after their amputation. And sometimes the pain is even worse than the fact of not having a hand. Like really the pain, among their priorities, they say pain is the worst thing that happened to me. Because they cannot sleep, they have to take a lot of medications. Now, what we found is that by giving phantom thermal sensation, in some of these patients, there was also reduction of phantom limb pain. It's not in the paper that you have seen, but it's part of our current study.
For the study, we work with Fabrizio, who's an arm amputee, who came with his own prosthetic, and we equipped it with our system. And using this technology, he could seamlessly move his own arm, but even more important, detect if he was touching a human hand or a fake hand. Now, this social part of touch is something that opens new perspective into the prosthetic world. What is exciting is that the study shows that the technology is mature to leave the lab and could now potentially enhance the life of patients using it.
So the challenges were technical challenges, really. I think the main one we had was to make this something robust. Also, once you talk about temperature, energy becomes a big problem. You don't want to have a huge battery. So we worked a lot into making this miniaturized, something that is only a few hundred grams. With one single charge, this could work for 16 hours. So a patient eventually could charge it as they do with their cell phone during the night and then use it the whole day and it will work. So that was the challenges were really on energy efficiency and robustness. Okay, I'm from Afghanistan originally. I moved to Switzerland about when I was 12 years old. So I lived in a country where that has sadly one of the highest rate of amputation in the world. So once I studied this engineering and I started working into neuroengineering, working on amputees was something that was really deeply meaningful for me. I think what motivates me is really, the responses of the patients. It is one of those studies. I mean, we do many different things and then some of them could work. Some of them you come back many, many times. And then at the end, you it's research. There is up and downs, and the downs are much more often, honestly. Like, there's a lot of moments where things do not work. And when you have something that works so well with patients, it really gives you this motivation to go beyond and try to make this something that could be used by many more. And then I would say this part about the phantom limb pain, it's something I really would like to have a proper clinical trial. Really demonstrate this as a strong proof that it's something that could reduce their pain. And hopefully, if that is the case, then having the majority of patients with phantom limb pain one day, hopefully using this technology.